As per the latest report published by Gartner, Microsoft Azure is the leading cloud provider. As you have seen the growth of Microsoft in the last few years, this might be one of the best time to learn Microsoft Azure Cloud and upskill yourself. So in this video, I will give you the complete guide on how you can master Microsoft Azure Cloud, get certified, and do one complete end-to-end project in data engineering. So in the first part of this video, we will talk about some of the important services you need to focus on as a data engineer. So do not skip this part, because if you want to learn different services on Microsoft Azure, I will give you the clear explanation of these services. And in the second phase of this video, I will give you the complete roadmap where you can learn all of these different things, get certified, and do the project. I started my career by learning AWS. Okay, so AWS Cloud was my first cloud platform that I learned. Then I learned about GCP and Azure. One thing that I've learned is that once you learn one cloud, it is very easy for you to learn any other cloud in the market, because fundamentally all of these cloud services are same. So in this video, I just want to cover about the Azure services, but if you want me to make videos on AWS and GCP, I will definitely do that. Remember this, all of these cloud platforms have more than hundreds of services available. The good thing is that you don't need to learn all of them. You just need to focus on some of the 15 to 20 data services that you will use as a data engineer. So first, I will give you the understanding of some of the most important services you need to focus on Azure Cloud, and then we can talk about the roadmap and all of the other things. So here are the 10 different services you need to focus on as an Azure data engineer. Number 10 on the list is Azure Storage. It is an object storage where you can store all of the different types of files that you want. So even if you have images, audios, videos, text files, you can easily store it on Azure Storage and integrate it with some other services. And we will talk about other services where you can integrate all of these different technologies, but for now just understand Azure Storage is where you can store any types of file that you want and easily access it from anywhere in the world. Number 9 on the list is Azure SQL Database. So as a data engineer, one of the skills you need to have is understanding of the SQL, because it is the way you communicate with the databases. And Azure SQL Database service is provided by Azure when you want to store all of these data in structured format. If you have been following me from the past, you know that we talk about OLTP and OLAP databases. So this is the OLTP database that is designed for cloud operation, create, read, update, delete. Okay, so if you want to connect your application to the relational database, this is the service that you use, Azure SQL Database. Number 8 on the list is Azure Cosmos DB. Now this is the center of modern engineering, because this particular database is generally used for high scale applications. The Cosmos DB supports different types of databases such as PostgreSQL, Cassandra, MongoDB. So it supports both the SQL and the NoSQL databases. So if you want to develop the high performance and high scale application, then you can easily do that using Cosmos DB. 7th on the list is Azure HD Insight. Now when you enter in the big data world, you generally hear about Hadoop, Spark, Hive, MapReduce, and all of the other things. These are open source frameworks generally used for processing data. Now, if you want to install all of these applications on your PC, you will have to do a lot of different configuration, and you will have to get the sizes of the hard disk, RAMs, all of the other things together to process large scale data. Now, HD Insight is a service provided by Azure where you don't have to manage anything. You can just click one button and have these entire frameworks configured automatically. So you can just focus on processing your data and do not worry about the underlying infrastructure. So this is a very good service if you want to process your data on scale. Number 6 on the list is Azure Data Lake Storage. So now Data Lake is basically the centralized repository where you can store all of your data. So in data engineering, we have data coming from the multiple places, right? We have the RDB, DBMS, web analytics, some APIs, third-party data, and all of these data are coming from the multiple sources. What we really need to do, we need to aggregate all of this data at centralized location. This is what we call as a data lake, where you just store all of this data as it is, and as per the requirement, business people or the data analyst or data engineers can choose the right amount of data. This is what we generally call as a schema on read. Okay, based on the requirement, you choose the data that you want, and then you can do the analytics on top of it. So Azure Data Lake Generation 2 or EDLS is a service built for this only. It will help you to build a data lake on Azure Cloud where you can easily organize your data and retrieve it whenever you want. Number 5th on the list is Azure Stream Analytics. So in day-to-day basis, we see a lot of application of real-time data streaming, right? Google Maps, Uber, all of these applications gives you the real-time notification about your events, okay? So if you order something from, let's say, Zomato, if you order something from the Amazon, you get the notification at each and every place, such as your order is confirmed, your order is shipped, your order is returned. All of these information are coming at you in real-time manner. So if you want to build the application something like this, and if you want to process your data in real-time, Azure Stream Analytics is a service you go for. Number 4th on the list is Azure Machine Learning. Now this service is mainly used by data scientists and machine learning engineers, but as a data engineer, it is really important for you to understand all of these different services, because you will be working at the business side also and also engineering side. So it is really important that you understand the use case of Azure Machine Learning services, and this topic is also important for your certification exam. So Azure Machine Learning service is generally used for building, training and testing your machine learning model on large scale. Now these are the 7 services that are important, but next 3 services that I will be talking about is one of the most important from the real world point of view and also the exam point of view. So number 3 on the list is we have Azure Data Factory. Now we understood, right? As a data engineer, we have data coming from multiple sources. We want to process all of this data and store this data onto some target location. Now Azure Data Factory service is built for that only. So if you want to create the data pipeline on large scale, where you want to extract data from some sources, do some transformation, apply some logic, and you know, build your pipeline in between by aggregating different logics, you can easily do that using Azure Data Factory. It has the drag and drop environment, so you can choose the action based on your work and create the complete data pipeline. And the best part about this service is that you can integrate this service with any other services available on Azure or even outside Azure. So if you want to retrieve data from, let's say, some APIs, you can easily do that on Data Factory. Number 2 on the list is Azure Synapse Analytics. So at the end of our data pipeline, we want to aggregate all of the data, put it in the structure format and load it somewhere. In Azure Cloud, you can load your data on Synapse Analytics, which is kind of like the data warehouse service provided by Azure. You can also do a lot of things on Synapse Analytics. You can also build your data factory pipeline. You can also do the transformation. You can write SQL code. You can write Spark code. All of these different things provided by Azure in one single service, so you don't have to worry about jumping to the different services. But the core idea behind Synapse Analytics is to build a data warehouse so that you can analyze your data in efficient manner. So if you want to understand about, let's say, in the case of Amazon, like what was the last 6 years of revenue compared to this year, or how much product did we sell this month compared to the previous 6 months, you can do all of these analytics using SQL and also the Python or the Spark language provided by Azure Synapse Analytics. And the number 1 on the list is Azure Databricks. Now Databricks is like the managed environment for Apache Spark. Apache Spark is an open source framework used for processing big data tools, but again, installation of all of these different tools is very difficult. You have to configure a lot of different things. So if you use Databricks, within a one single button, you can configure your entire environment and just focus on writing your logic and do not worry about the underlying environment. Now, Microsoft did the partnership with Databricks and integrated this service on Azure Cloud. So you can get most out of all of these different Azure services. So if you want to connect Azure Databricks with, let's say, Synapse Analytics or Azure Data Lake Storage, you can easily do that because Microsoft provides all of these different integration in the backend. So within a few lines of code, you can easily access data from ADA, do the transformation and load your data onto, let's say, Synapse Analytics using Azure Databricks services. So these 3 services that I talked about, Azure Data Factory, Synapse Analytics and Azure Databricks, is one of the most important services you need to focus on if you want to learn Azure Cloud from data engineering point of view. Now these were the important services, but there are some other services or the new services that are coming in the market. So one of the services we have is the Data Fabric. Now this service is very new in the market. It was launched 6 months back, so all you can do is just learn about this service and what is the use case of it. As we move forward, we will understand how companies are using this service in their business, and then we can, you know, start talking about if this service is important or not. And if I missed any of the services that you have in your mind, and if you're working on Azure Cloud, then you can definitely comment it out so that I will get to know about it, and also other people in the comment section can also learn about it. So we talked about some of the important services. Now let's focus on how you can learn all of these services on the first place. So what is the roadmap to become Azure data engineer? better. So the first step I always suggest is to not run behind the theories and the courses and all of the other things. The first thing you need to do is go onto the portal.azure.com and create your free account. Azure provides $200 credit for free and 12 month free trial on some of the services. So the first thing I want you to do is go create your account. Okay, it is completely free. All you have to do is fill the basic information. You won't get charged for any of these things, and once you do that, you can easily access the Azure Cloud Portal and start understanding about the different services provided by the Azure. This first step is very important because you will get used to the UI of Azure Cloud, because whenever we start learning about something new, there is a little bit discomfort in our brain that the new information is coming to you and you don't understand it. So all I want you to do is, the first step is create your account. Once you create your account, you will get the confidence that I took the first step to learn something new. Now once you create your Azure account, then the second thing you can do is go through this amazing free training provided by the Microsoft. This is freely available. All you want to do is go through this step by step and learn everything. I will provide links to all of these different things in my Notion document, so you can just check the link in the description and understand more about it. So after doing this training, you will understand most of the things you need to know as an Azure data engineer, but doing a good course on this will give you the more confidence that you actually understood about all of these different things using hands-on practice. So this is one of the best course available in the market on Coursera, Microsoft Azure Data Engineering Associate. Now this course will teach you everything you need to know to become Azure data engineer. This course starts with the basics. So first you will have the clear understanding of the data engineering, why we do data engineering in the first place and the impact of it. And then as you move forward, you will get more understanding about the different services, how they come together. You will also get the hands-on lab. So this course is freely available if you just want to audit it, but if you want to get the certification, then you have to pay for it. So it's up to you. If you just want to learn from it, just go through the videos, you will get most of the understanding, and then you can move on to the next step. So once you complete your course on Coursera, then the next thing I suggest you to do is understand how to combine all of these services and build a final project together. And for that, I have one free end-to-end project available on my YouTube channel called as Olympics Data Analysis End-to-End Azure Data Engineering Project. This project will give you understanding about the various services, the important services that we talked about, such as Data Factory, Databricks, Synapse Analytics, ADLS, all of these important services, and you will build a final project. So I will highly encourage you to do this project after completing all of these different courses. So after completing this project, your confidence will skyrocket and you can easily appear for the certification exam. So if you want to validate your knowledge and if you want to, you know, stand out from the crowd when applying for the jobs, you can get the certification from Microsoft. They have this certification available, Azure Data Engineering Associate. Having this certification on your resume makes you stand out from the crowd and also validate your knowledge as an Azure Data Engineer. So when a recruiter sees that you have done the certification, the chances of getting calls for the interview increases. I cleared this exam in just 7 days and I have created the complete guide on this also. So if you want, you can just look at this video and start watching it. This will give you the complete understanding of how you can get certification, everything about certification, from the cost, how much time does it take, and different resources that I use to clear this certification. This was all from this video. If you learned something new and if you found this video helpful, then don't forget to hit the like button. This helps this channel to grow and reach more and more people. If you are new here, don't forget to hit the subscribe button. Thank you for watching. I'll see you in the next.